Hey, what's up, guys? As you know, I'm Jason, bringing you another YouTube video, and this one is the first ever episode of the new series called Tournament Tuesdays. And for the first ever episode, I thought it'd be a cool idea for me and my best friend Tyson. We both picked 8 superstars. We have a 16-man King of the Ring, and if one of our 8 superstars is the winner, that means we are the first ever Tournament Tuesdays champion. So let's get into it. I already have the King of the Ring set up, which is cool. Continue. So the first match will be Roman Reigns versus Triple H. Reigns is Tyson's first superstar, mine is Triple H. Now for Tyson, AJ Styles, for me, Edge. John Cena versus HBK. Dean Ambrose versus Jeff Hardy. Daniel Bryan versus Chris Jericho. Cesaro versus Matt Hardy. Dolph Ziggler versus Kevin Owens. Sami Zayn versus Christian. Now, every top superstar is Tyson's superstar. Every bottom superstar is mine. And I'm not going to play any of these matches to make it fair. It's going to be the computer playing against the computer. And let's get into the first match. Roman Reigns. Oh, and by the way, before we get into the first match, every match is Extreme Rules, and damage retention is on. So damage from match to match carries over. Now let's get into the first match: Roman Reigns versus Triple H. Computer versus computer. And I'll see you when we get into the match. Roman Reigns, Tyson's first superstar. And here comes the King of Kings. And this is going to be a great match, a WrestleMania 32 rematch in the first match of the tournament. And let's hope the same result from WrestleMania 32 does not happen from here. We had to see the water spit. We had to see it. Okay. So let's get into the match. Oh, Reigns. Oh, pulls Triple H right into a belly-to-belly suplex. Triple H counters. Nice. Sorry about that, guys. Little interruption, but you didn't miss much. And here we go. Oh, trips with a knife, with a Ric Flair like knife edge chop. Oh. Trips counters, side headlock. Oh, and the big back elbow. Oh, there, another one. And there's the third. Trips just dominating right now. But so yeah, this series, it's gonna be a very interesting one. And not every episode of the series will be WWE. It could be a tournament in any game, because this channel is not just a wrestling channel. It's just a pretty much any game that I feel like playing channel. But and remember, every match is Extreme Rules, and Triple H is gonna take advantage of that. Getting a ladder for some reason. I mean, I would have personally thought he would have got the sledgehammer. You know, the equalizer. Oh, no. Roman getting kendo sticks. Oh, never mind. Okay. Oh, big kick to the gut. Ah. Woo! The dirtiest player in the game. Oh, God. At this point, both just want to fight to see who can get underneath the ring first. Okay, here we go. Trip for the chair. Oh, he is Roman with a chair, but Roman no sells. Both inside the ring. And Reigns take the chair. And Roman takes the chair. Oh, and a big unprotected headshot. Oh, and Trips busting wide open with that unprotected headshot. Now just throwing the chair on him. Great. Rain bleeding all over the place. Counters Trips with a back suplex. Oh, now just working down the head. Which is kind of stupid, because Trips, the pedigree focuses on the head, but the spear is focused on the body. So, I mean, if you want to wear down someone for your finish, you know, you should do that with work on the body of your Reigns, not the head. But Trips. Oh! Reigns head first into that chair that he set up. The wrestling irony there. Trips going up top. Oh, counters. And axe handle. Okay, Trips wants to mess up the announce table. All right, redecorating. But he throws Reigns back in the ring. On another elbow to that face. Just waiting on the outside. Slides back in the ring as Reigns gets up. And that gives Reigns the opportunity to come back with a short arm clothesline. Now Reigns to the outside. Oh, he's going to get a weapon. Oh, the trash can. All right. Bringing out your old ECW, I guess? I don't know. I mean, actually, I shouldn't say old ECW, but just ECW in general. Now, Reigns with that elbow. Nice. Okay. Oh, now Reigns getting a... Ooh, the sledgehammer. Trips not letting that happen, though. As he throws him back in the ring. Okay, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Oh, and Trips thrown hard into the turnbuckle. Oh, follows Reigns to the outside. All right, what's going to happen here? Oh, Reigns hits him in the face with the steel steps. That can bust a man wide open. That'll hurt you. Oh, I don't know what happened there, but okay. Oh, look, it's on the outside. Trips. Pedigree on the outside. But remember, you have to pin inside the ring. That weakens your opponent, but you know, you still got to pin on the inside of the ring. Oh, Trips working off those legs. Smart strategy. You can't hit the spear if you can't run. Oh, big kick. Reigns counters. Samoan drop on the floor. And I'll just smash the head into the floor. Nice. Oh, Reigns scouted the clothesline again. With a counter with a drop toe hold. Oh, now. Oh, he looked like he was going for the baseball bat. Trips didn't let him get it. Oh, Reigns throws Trips to the inside. Oh, Trips rolls it back inside the ring. Oh, Reigns blocks a kick. Triple H shoves him away. Oh, Roman gets the advantage. And Trips takes the advantage with the face buster, driving the bloody face into the mat. Oh, going for the cover. One, two. Almost got the three. Oh, that was a near fall. Oh, Reigns with that short arm clothesline again. Now he's going for the cover. One. But he only gets the one. Is Roman Reigns going to win and have a WrestleMania 32 repeat? Or Trip's going to finally bring out his shovel and bury him? We'll find out. Oh, Reigns. Counters with a side wrestling leg sweep. Trips counters with the Irish whip. Reigns hangs onto the ropes. On Trips with the suplex back in the ring. Now he's going to the outside. Oh, now Trips is getting the baseball bat. And he's got it. Trash can versus baseball bat. I'd say trash can probably wins. And it does. Oh, Trips clothesline knocking Reigns down. Oh, Trips throwing the big fist. Oh, and Russell's leg sweep on the baseball bat. Head bounced off the baseball bat. Trips brings him to his feet. And spine buster on the baseball bat now. You gotta get him in the ring, Hunter. You gotta get him in the ring. That'll definitely weaken him. The DDT on the floor. Oh, now Reigns counters. The side wrestling leg sweep on the steel steps. Oh, Reigns counters. And puts Triple H back in the ring. Oh, Reigns got the ladder. Sets up on the outside. Trips coming to the outside. Collar and a tackle on the outside, that's first. I didn't think we'd see one of those in this match. Oh, a big headbutt. Oh, Reigns has got Trips. Oh, going for the neck breaker. Oh, no, counters. Oh, and a forearm to the back of the neck. He faked him out. Oh, now he's got him. Follow away slam into the ladder and on the steel steps. Oh, wow, the frame droppage. Wow. Did not expect that. Oh, now he's got him up. Oh, Trips counters and backbreaker. Oh, Reigns blocks the punch. Oh, he picks him up and slams him down on the floor. Head bounced off the baseball bat in the trash can. Oh, big punch by Reigns. Trips counters. And he trips over the baseball bat. Clumsy, clumsy Reigns. If you keep doing that, we can't have nice things. Oh, shin first into the steel steps. Oh, and a big kick to the gut again. Picks him up. Oh, he's going for a power bomb. Trips. Oh, and Trips counters with a DDT on the floor. Oh, Reigns blocks the punch again. And Trips throws him shin first into the steel steps again. Oh, Trips still got the advantage. Reigns trying to use the ladder. Oh, and he misses. Oh, shot to the face. Oh, and shot to the leg. Oh, hang on, guys. I'll be right back, okay? Okay, guys, we're back. And Reigns still got using that ladder to take out Trips. Another shot to the legs. Oh, kick. Oh, got him up, and Samoan drop on the floor. Now, this match is going on for a pretty long time. Did not expect this. Oh, Trips going for a DDT again. Reigns counters, drops him head first off the floor, almost on that ladder. Trips is lucky it wasn't on the ladder. On Reigns, powerbomb. You've got to get back in the ring, guys, or else you won't win the match. And finally getting back in the ring as Reigns, there's the elbow. Oh, on a headbutt, taking him down. On Reigns! Oh, Trips counts a Superman punch into a small package. One, two. On Reigns kicks out at two. On Trips, setting up for the end. Setting up for the pedigree. Oh, kick. Oh, he hooks the arm behind the back. And pedigree. And the game is game, set, match. And Triple H has picked up the win, meaning I'm one up on Tyson in the first ever Tournament Tuesdays tournament. But geez, man, that was a long match. That match was about 13 minutes. God. But, just looking at the replays, there's the counter of the Superman punch. And then Trips fighting step for the end. Second pedigree of the match. First one in the ring. Reigns busted wide open earlier in the match. And he picked up the win. Wow. What a match. And the King of Kings advances to the next round. I'll see when we get back to the main menu. Okay guys, we're back on the main menu, and the next match you'll see is AJ Styles versus Edge. I'll see you when we get into the match. Now this is going to be a really great match. Okay, here we go. Edge starts off with a drop kick on AJ Styles. AJ knows a lot about that. And here we go. Now I would literally pay to see this match if it could happen. There we go. So yeah, Edge still got the advantage over AJ. I flipped into the bottom right turnbuckle. On big clothesline. Oh, here we go. Oh, Edge pulls him back. AJ counters, belly to belly suplex. Oh, Edge counters with a drop toe hold. Well, AJ blocked the punch. Punch of his own. Side headlock. Knee to the gut. Oh, Irish rope. Pulls him back. Edge counters with a kick. Oh, AJ blocked the kick. Oh, and Edge shoves him away. One, here we go. Edge caught him with a flapjack. Oh, trading kicks. AJ counters. Irish whip. Remember, like I said, every single match of this tournament is Extreme Rules. And that's really interesting for this, as Edge catches him with another flapjack. And I don't know if this match will go... This match could be shorter than Triple H and Roman Reigns. It could be way longer. I hope it's not way longer, because I don't want this video to be like an hour and a half long. I'm sure some of you wouldn't mind that, by the way. Be like a special pay-per-view. But, oh god, AJ got him up. Oh, and it turns into a sidewalk slam. Beautiful. Oh, and some big kicks to the stomach and the back. But Edge... Oh, AJ stops him from hitting that drop kick again. Throws him to the turnbuckle. Oh, here we go. AJ with the Hurricanrana. Or head scissors, I guess, would be the correct term for that. Oh, AJ. Oh, Edge catches his own backbreaker on the ropes. Oh, Edge going up to the top rope. Oh, AJ got in the ring before, so Edge couldn't hit him with that cross body. Oh, Edge counters though. Stomp to the calf. Oh, AJ misses the drop kick. Edge misses the grab. Edge goes behind. Oh, and DDT head bouncing off the floor. Oh, Edge brings him up to his feet. Oh, AJ counters. Edge bounced off the ring apron. And DDT on the floor. Now, AJ going up top. Oh, thinking about it. Oh, he gets Edge to jump off the apron, but AJ landed hard on the mat. Now Edge going up top. Oh, Edge counters. Oh, AJ caught him out of midair. And backbreaker. Oh, and now elbow to the leg. That's a perfect move because it'll weaken the legs, setting up perfectly for the calf killer. Oh, AJ counters, drop to a hold. Edge down to the mat. Oh, Edge gets up, shoves AJ away. Oh, AJ catches him with a Hurricanrana. Oh, big kick there. Oh, Edge gets up and takes the legs out. Oh, AJ gets up and gets the advantage right back. But Edge takes the advantage right back with a side rush and leg sweep. Bring him up to his feet. Edge gets him. AJ counters the Irish whip. Oh, and catches him with another Hurricanrana. Oh, finally some weapons getting introduced in the match. Oh, wait, never mind. Edge keeps him from getting that chair. Oh, but a big super kick. Oh, now AJ... Oh, he had the sledgehammer, but Edge made him drop it. Edge shoves him away. Oh, and a clothesline by Edge, taking down AJ Styles. Edge looking for a weapon. AJ's not going to let him get one. Oh, and Edge... Smart, don't let AJ use that sledgehammer. Oh, Edge takes the crutch from the fan who offered it to him. Oh, AJ! Oh, now they're fighting over the crutch. I hope that person did not need that crutch, let me tell you. Because I don't think they're getting it back. Oh, Pele! Pele on the outside. Ow. I hate coughing. Oh, Edge threw a little bit of a tantrum there, throwing this crutch down on the steel steps. Oh, AJ keeps him from hitting him with the chair. Oh, he hit some big punches and discus forearm, more punches. Oh, Edge counters into the gut. Oh, AJ, big forearm. Oh, Edge throws him to the barricade and now just rain it down with the right hands. Some big right hands there from Edge. Those are hurt. You're all right. Oh, but Edge shin first into the steel steps. Oh, here we go. Oh, lifting underhook DDT. Oh, wow. Now, AJ goes shin first into the steps. Oh, but counters with a drop toe hold. Oh, bringing him up to his feet. Oh, blocks the punch. Oh, Edge counters forearm to the back. Oh, no. Edge doesn't let him use the chair. Instead, throws him into the steel steps again. On a clothesline. AJ landing next to that steel chair. Brings him up to his feet. Oh, Edge, here we go. Execution on the floor. AJ landing on that steel chair. Oh, and now, downward spiral on the floor. Two straight variations of the DDT bouncing AJ's head off the onto the floor. Oh, Edge going for it. Oh, AJ counters, elbow to the side of the head. And I'll throw it. Oh, Edge bounced off the barricade. Oh, okay. Edge counters with a snapmare. Oh, and now AJ counters. Kick to the midsection. Now AJ, he's got him up again. Oh, and burning hammer! Edge's legs are bouncing off the steel steps. Oh, Edge not allowing the headshot with the chair. Oh, AJ with some big punches. Edge bounced off the barricade again. Oh, Edge counters. And belly to belly on the floor. Oh, AJ blocks the punch. Oh, there's another Pele. Now, oh, AJ looking for another chair. And he gets it. Edge still not letting him get hit him with it. Oh, AJ takes it back. Oh, Edge punch. Oh, and Tatuara Hokkanrana by AJ Styles on the floor. Oh, Edge moves out the way of the elbow and hits him with that clothesline again. This match is turning out like the last match. Oh, Edge with a big snap DDT. But this match ends up like the last match, which mainly took place on the outside. Looks like that one's gonna go the same way. Oh, AJ takes the advantage. Neither man has been hit with a weapon yet. They're both fighting over the weapons, but they can't hit him with it. But here we go. AJ with the neck breaker, driving the knee right into the neck. Oh, now, oh, here we go. And burning hammer by AJ. AJ's head landed directly on that steel chair. Now AJ looking for the baseball bat. Will a weapon actually finally come into play? No, it does not. They're both fighting over the baseball bat now. You know, you two have to get in the ring to win, though. Oh, AJ with some big punches. And now he's got him up again, and there's the neck breaker again. The fireman's carry neck breaker, bring him up to his feet. Edge counter with a knee to the midsection. Now, AJ counters with a forearm to the back. What a super kick. Oh, and Edge thrown into the ring. Elbow to the face. AJ on the outside. Edge comes back to the outside to fight. AJ getting the steel steps. Oh, he puts him down though. Edge bounced off that ring post. Oh, AJ. Oh no. Don't do this, AJ. Don't do it. Don't do it. Oh! Big boot directly to the... Big boot. Two head. Two ring post. Oh, but Edge managed to counter with a DDT. And AJ bounced off that sledgehammer from earlier in the match. Edge busted wide open from the big boot to the ring post. And now AJ in the ring. Who now just staring each other down. Edge to the inside of the ring. Oh, AJ blocks the kick. Dragon whip leg screw. Now he's got the steel chair. Slides back in the ring. Oh, Edge. AJ counters. One. Two. Edge matched a kick out of two. Oh, now Edge with that same counter going for the cover. One. Two. And he gets the two. Oh, spear out of nowhere. Oh my god, the spear just came out of nowhere. Pin him, Edge. Pin him. Rolling into the cover. But did he take too much time? Yet, no, he did not. And Edge picks up the win. That means I am up 2-0 on Tyson. But that means nothing. Because both of my men could... And that also means two of my men are facing each other in the next round. Triple H versus Edge in the next round. And wow, there's the execution where AJ ended up going... Oh, here's his big move. Big boot with Edge's head colliding with the ring post. That was... It busted Edge open, but Edge managed to come back. See here, as AJ got up, out of nowhere there was a spear. And Edge picked up the win. So, Triple H beat Roman Reigns. Edge beat AJ Styles. That means, so far, looks like looking like I've got the advantage over Tyson in this. I'll see when we get back to the main menu for the next match. Hey, what's up, guys? So welcome back to we're back. And we just saw two great matches. And now it's time for John Cena versus Shawn Michaels. I'll see you when we get into it. Okay, let's get into it. John Cena and Shawn Michaels. WrestleMania 23 rematch. Oh, Shawn's starting off fast with a fist drop. Chase of the old Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. Oh, and a back body drop. Oh, Shawn with some big kicks. And Cena knows he's got to avoid those kicks from Shawn, because Shawn could hit that sweet chin music from out of nowhere. Oh, missed the drop kick. Oh, they bump into each other. Cena with a wrist lock. Oh, Shawn counters. Oh, and an enziguri. Oh, big Ric Flair-like knife edge chops. Cena counters into a side headlock. And Cena with the gut buster. Oh, Shawn blocks a punch. Punch of his own. And another Ric Flair-like knife edge chop. Brings him up to his feet. Oh, Shawn with some punches and chops. Oh, got him with a wrist lock. Cena counter with a knee to the gut. Oh, Shawn, here we go. He's got him up, and the suplex. Sorry about that, guys. But we're back, and you literally didn't miss anything. But Cena just threw him in. Oh, big punch to the face. Shawn kicks his way out of the corner. Oh, Cena with a fireman's carry. You know, so far, I've got the advantage over Tyson in this tournament. Which is awesome. You know, between these two, actually, I don't think we'd see as many, like, weapon shots than between, like, Reigns and Hunter. Or even Edge and Styles. Oh, Shawn. Oh, counter the shoulder block. And Shawn coming to the outside. Oh, back on the apron. Oh, going up top. Oh, Cena throws Shawn off the top. Oh, now Cena. Oh, snap in the neck. Oh, Shawn blocks the punch. And, oh, Cena counters, taking him down. Now Cena to the outside. Oh, Cena back on the apron. Now Cena going up top. Oh, Shawn with a chop. Oh, and he counters. And powerbomb out of midair. Oh. Cena moves out the way. The kicks. Goes behind. Oh, Shawn counters. Oh, Cena takes the advantage. Shawn counters the drop to home. Oh, Cena counters. Punch to the face. Oh, and a shoulder block. Well, Cena flips him over. Oh, Shawn counters, not letting him get the submission. But Cena takes the advantage. Shawn counters. Shawn going to the outside. Now, Cena on the outside, too. Well, Cena shoves him away. Oh, Shawn comes out of nowhere. There's the foot over net breaker. And Shawn on the apron. Oh, going up top again. Looking at Shawn. Oh, Cena moves out the way of the drop kick. And now, Luthes press. Luthes press by Cena. Now, Cena's up on the apron. Oh, Shawn pulls him down. Sending him down to the floor. Oh, and Cena puts him back in the ring. Oh, Shawn comes back to the outside. Oh, and an inverted atomic drop. And puts Cena back in the ring. Oh. Okay. Shawn comes back to the inside of the ring. Shawn counters. Oh, Cena from out of nowhere, the bulldog. Now he goes to the outside. Cena looking for a weapon. Oh, it looks like he's going to try and get a chair. And he's got it. Cena with a chair, slides back into the ring. Shawn walking to the outside. Oh, and he's going to follow him. Oh, Shawn Michaels baited him. Hits him with a flying forearm and a kip up. Shawn perfectly baited him. Oh, catch him with an inverted atomic drop again. Kick. Oh. Shawn steals the chair. Oh, Cena, big punches. Oof. Oh. They both slide back in the ring and. Oh, Cena counter side rushing leg sweep. Okay. Oh, big shot to the face. I think Cena was set up for that attitude adjustment. If he did or not, I don't know, but Shawn counters. Oh, Cena moves out the way of the drop kick. Oh, and sweet chin music! Sweet chin music from out of nowhere! One, two, three! And just like that, Shawn Michaels in quick fashion beats John Cena. Which is amazing, because that puts me up 3-0 against Tyson. Looks like Tyson, he didn't pick his superstars too well for this tournament. But it looks like I did. As Triple H beats Roman Reigns, Edge beats AJ Styles, and the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, knocks out the face of the WWE, John Cena. And I'll see you when we get back into the main... Wow. I still can't believe what we've seen so far. I mean, Tyson is down 3-0 right now, which is good for me. But, let's not focus on that too much. Let's just focus on the next match, the fourth match of the tournament, which is Tyson's Dean Ambrose versus my Jeff Hardy. Let's get into it. I'll see you when we get into the match. You know, guys, I didn't know Ambrose's entrance was that short. Jeff Hardy. Okay, let's get into this fourth match. And you know. Oh, Ambrose with a side versus leg sweep. Jeff, don't let me down. Do not let me down, Jeff. I mean, Ambrose has got the advantage right now. But come on, Jeff, don't let me down. But anyway, just let you know, guys, the tournament, the way I'm going to be splitting the tournament up, I'm going to be putting each round, like, each round is going to be its own episode. So you have the preliminary round, which is round one, then you have the quarterfinals, round two, semifinals, round three, and then the finals, round four. And, I forget, that's a smart way to do it that way. If I did it all in one, the video would be way too long, and I'm not going to do that. And I figure with it doing it this way, I'll also get 4 Tournament Tuesday episodes out of it, which I think is a pretty good deal, if you know what I mean. But anyway, Ambrose with a swinging neck breaker. Someone's got to, you know, start winning for Tyson's side, because if I keep winning, oof. It's not going to look good for Tyson, if you know what I mean. But anyway, Ambrose gets hit with that side rush and leg sweep. Oh, and Ambrose with a spine buster. Beautiful spine buster. On Ambrose to the outside. Ambrose already looking for the weapons. Oh, Hardy says, not today. Not today, Dean. Oh, here we go. Float over Netbreaker. Now, the last two matches, we didn't see, like, any weapon shots at all. Between, you know, Edge and Styles and Cena and Michaels. But this one, I think we're going to see a lot of weapons. I mean, just look back at, like, any of Ambrose's matches, especially on the indie scene, and look back on any Jeff Hardy match, pretty much. Oh my god. This match should have a lot of weapons. It wouldn't be a Jeff Hardy or Dean Ambrose match without weapons, if you know what I mean. But, anyway. Right now, Jeff Hardy just seems to, like hitting that belly-to-belly suplex on Dean Ambrose. Because, of course he does. And, oh, Jeff headfirst into the ring post. Oh, Jeff counters, though. Knee to the gut. Dean counters, forearm to the back. Oh, no, takes him down with a drop kick. Nice. Oh, Ambrose up on the apron. Oh, Ambrose going up to the top. And missile drop kick connecting. Yep, the missile drop kick was connecting. Oh, Hardy moves out the way of the knee, but he runs right into the spine buster by Ambrose. Now Ambrose rolls underneath the bottom rope again to the outside, looking for the table, and Jeff doesn't let him get one. Oh, Hardy with the back suplex on the floor. We've seen the majority of the action tonight, it has been featured on the outside of the ring. And oh my god, Hardy with a suplex, just grabbing him by the neck and throwing him over his head. Well, I don't even know what to call that suplex, but it looked brutal, let me tell you. Oh no, Ambrose with that foot of a neck breaker, this time on the exposed floor. Ambrose throws Hardy back in the ring. Oh, Ambrose coming back inside too. Oh now, oh, Ambrose pulls him back. Jeff counters into the jawbreaker. Now, Jeff going to the outside. Oh no. Going to the top rope. And Ambrose throws him off the top rope. Rookie mistake. Oh, Ambrose with the dragon sleeper. He's got the dragon sleeper. We have a bad angle of it, but ref says Jeff did not tap. Oh, Jeff counters into a snapmare. And big knee drop. Oh, Jeff, two in a row. Rolls outside the ring. Oh, here we go. Jeff with the alley-oop face buster. The big face buster. One, two, three. And Jeff Hardy. Wow, that match was quicker than John Cena and Shawn Michaels. And just like that, I am up 4-0 on Tyson. That is not good for him, but great for me. And Jeff Hardy quickly just disposes of Dean Ambrose right there with that face buster. The match was just about 7 minutes. God, first you get the super long match between Triple H and Roman Reigns, and it's just been getting shorter and shorter. But anyway, Hardy wins, and I'll see you when we get back to the main event. Or not the main event, but the main menu. Okay, you know, I can't believe what we just saw. I mean, I'm up 4-0, was it amazing? But I can't believe Jeff Hardy just dominated Dean Ambrose like that. I mean, it was the shortest match we've seen so far. But anyway, next is Daniel Bryan and Tyson's Daniel Bryan versus my Chris Jericho, and we'll see who wins that one. And for Tyson's sake, he better hope Daniel can pick up the win. But let's get into it. Yeah, let the CPU go at it, and I'll see you when we get to the entrances. Okay, here we are. You know, if any match has the potential of being a long one, it's definitely this one. Daniel Bryan, Chris Jericho, two technical wrestling masters. Yeah, this one definitely should be a longer one, but who knows? Who knows? I don't. You know, this is going to be a great one. At least I think it will be. And like I said, for Tyson's sake, he better, like, be like, Tyson, if you're watching this, you better hope Daniel can pick up the win. Okay? You better hope. Because you're down 4-0 right now, and if Jericho picks up the win, there's not many other top-level guys you have in this tournament. Besides Daniel, so, yeah, you better hope Daniel can pick up the win. Oh, one, sorry about that, and two, let's get into the match. Oh, Jericho quickly takes down Bryan with a drop kick. Oh, Chris brings him up to his feet. Oh, Daniel counters with a side rush and leg sweep. Alright, Daniel. Oh, Jericho now with that side rush and leg sweep. Saying, what you can do, I can do better, I guess. Daniel with some with a kick and a punch. Jericho with a side headlock. Daniel counters with a drop tail hold. Oh, Jericho counters the Irish whip. Oh, Bryan flies off the ropes, floats over, and then drops him with a neck breaker. Oh, collar up a tie up. Bryan with a wrist lock takes him down by the arm. You know, set working that arm, setting up for the yes lock. Oh, okay, brings him up to his feet, side headlock. Jericho counters, back elbow. Oh, big punch to the back. On Jericho with a back suplex. Oh, Daniel moves out the way of the kick, but Jericho slams him down head first. A couple of big kicks, side headlock by Chris. Now Daniel with that elbow. Oh, Daniel to the outside. Now Daniel looking for the trash can. Chris doesn't let him get it. Oh, Chris counters the flying elbow with dropping him down again. Now Chris can't get the weapon because of Daniel. Oh, Chris got Daniel behind. Daniel hits the two back elbows. Okay. Chris with the kick to the midsection. Daniel with the punch grabs him. And Chris takes him down, sweeping the legs. But Chris thrown underneath the bottom rope. Oh, shot to the throat. And Daniel with a kick to the back of the head. Now Daniel looking for that weapon again. Well, this time looking for the sledgehammer. And he does not get it. He can't pull it out. Oh, Chris. Counts with a hip toss, but Daniel. Oh, Chris moves out the way of the enziguri. Brings him up to his feet. Oh, Daniel counters the flying forearm with the arm bar, or the arm drag, not arm bar. They bump into each other. Oh, Chris takes the crutch, but. And again, just like in the Edge and Styles match, I hope that person did not need that crutch because they're not getting it back. Oh, Daniel just throwing Jericho with on that suplex. Oh, kicks to the gut, hooks the arms. Oh, Chris counters with a kick to the midsection and Northern Light suplex, the Unbreakable 2005. Now Chris looking under the ring, but Daniel keeps him from getting anything. Oh, floats over, and Daniel drops him with a neck breaker on the floor this time. Oh, Daniel. German suplex. I guess Daniel's the master of Suplex and Submission City. Anything else? Well, Daniel got the ladder, but Chris makes him drop it. Oh, and Chris thrown into the barricade. Now Daniel, oh, big right hand. Daniel just, I'm raining down on the right hands. Oh, now Daniel's got the steps. Looks like Daniel just wants to hurt Chris. Oh, Chris gets hit. Oh, big shot to the face with the steel steps. Oh, Chris moves out the way. Oh, and he forces Daniel to finally drop the steps. Chris looked like he had something in mind, but he stops Daniel from kicking him with the elbow to the leg. Now he's got the sledgehammer. Oh, Daniel takes the sledgehammer now. Oh, shot to his face. Oh, and now Daniel just choking Chris out with his sledgehammer. That can end a match. That could end a match. I mean, not on the outside, of course. Oh, Chris moves out the way. Kick. Oh, but he lets Daniel get the upper hand. Oh, big kick. And now the yes kicks. The big kicks from Daniel. Yes. 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 And... oh! And the big shot to the head. Chris Jericho could be out cold right now. Oh, yes, look on the outside. But it means nothing. You have to win on the inside of the ring. Oh, it looked like Chris was tapping out, but it didn't matter. It did not matter at all. You have to win on the inside, not on the outside. So that gives Chris the upper hand. Oh, shot to the throat, and now kick to the back of the head. Daniel did that to Chris earlier. Oh, Chris looking for the baseball bat. And he's got it. Oh, but he drops it when Daniel comes outside the ring. Oh, and neck breaker on the sledgehammer. Now Daniel looking for a table, but Chris doesn't let him get that. Oh, Daniel counters with an arm drag again. Oh, big flying forearm as he gets in the ring. Oh, Daniel kipped up right at the right time. Oh, now, Daniel. Oh, Irish whip. Oh, Chris reverses the Irish whip. Oh, Daniel. Oh, up and over. Oh, Daniel ducks the clothesline. And flying elbow. Big flying elbow. And to the outside. Oh, Daniel redecorating the announce table. They just got their announce table cover back from the first match. And now, and Chris. Punches him off the apron. Now Chris. Oh, Chris back on the apron. Oh, back in the ring. Oh, and a flying forearm by Chris Jericho. Oh, springboards in, but Daniel counters. And now, oh, I thought he was going for the running knee. But looks like he's gonna go for the yes lock again. And there it is, the yes lock. He's got the yes lock on Jericho. The yes lock on Jericho. And Jericho taps out. And that means Tyson finally picks up a win because of Daniel Bryan. And you know, and Tyson, I know if you're watching this, you're probably chanting yes right now because Daniel finally picked up a win. And that is your first win in this tournament. Is he here? There's the German on the outside. He set it up. He called for it. And then he locked it in. There's the yes lock. And then Jericho, he had to tap. And that's what happened. And Daniel is, you know, he's happy about that. And I know Tyson is happy that he finally picked up a win. I'll see you when we get back to the main menu. Okay, so lucky for Tyson, Daniel picked up the win. But let's get into the next match between Cesaro and Matt Hardy. Those will be a very interesting one, kind of different styles colliding. Let the computer duke it out. And I guess you could say in this one, will Cesaro's power get the better of Matt? Or will Matt be able to use his speed and his technical wrestling ability to take out Cesaro? We'll find out. Yeah, let's find that out. I'll see when we get into the match.
for nothing short of a victory here tonight. The Raw crowd here tonight is definitely fired up for this one.
And his opponent I never get that right. Okay, let's let this computer duke it out. Matt Hardy representing me, Cesaro representing Tyson. Can Cesaro pick Tyson up a second win? Right now he gets the early advantage with a back suplex on Matt Hardy. Okay. I'm sure Matt would like to go into the finals against his brother Jeff. But Cesaro's got the advantage right now. As he's just... working the arm now. Cesaro's got the clear advantage. Hit three moves in a row. But Matt, he's going to stop that as he hits an elbow right to the throat. Nice move by Matt as he brings him up to his feet. Some big punches. Cesaro blocks the third. Goes behind. On another back suplex. Oh, Matt blocks the kick. Hits the dragon whip leg screw. And drops the elbow. Oh, Cesaro counters. Belly to belly. Oh, Cesaro. Michinoku driver. Oh, and drops the knee. Oh. Two knees in a row. Looks like Cesaro was watching the match that Jeff Hardy had with Dean Ambrose. Cesaro was first ushered to the ring by the side headlock. And God, look, Cesaro was really watching the match that Jeff Hardy had with Dean Ambrose as he hits the same exact suplex that Jeff hit on Ambrose. Cesaro's got, man, oh, Matt needs to the gut. Matt needs to pick it up. Because right now Cesaro just got that advantage. Matt working on the legs of Cesaro. Very smart. You work on the legs of Cesaro, he can't hit that giant swing. Oh, Cesaro counters. Oh, Matt rolls out the way of the knee. Oh, Cesaro! German suplex. Now Cesaro going to the outside. Oh, he's looking for a weapon. Oh, he wants the baseball bat. And he does get it out from underneath the ring, but Matt doesn't let him use it. And Matt puts him back in the ring. Matt said, I don't want none of that. I ain't got time for that. But, oh, Cesaro bounces off the turnbuckle. Oh, counters, goes behind, forearm to the back. And Cesaro spins him around. Matt counters with a side Russian leg sweep. All right. Oh, and drops the elbow. Now, Matt. Oh, Matt wants to go off the top. Cesaro's not going to let that happen. Oh, no. Matt counters punch to the face. Oh, Cesaro moves out the way of the elbow. And hits a European uppercut. Oh, and a big double stomp. Oh, Cesaro counters. Matt counters with the elbow. Drops the elbow again. Oh, Matt's big punches. On again, working on that leg. Just slamming the leg into the Matt. Oh, Matt looking for a chair. Cesaro grabs the baseball bat. Chair versus baseball bat. What wins? The chair does. And now Matt back to the inside of the ring. Oh, wedges the chair. We saw that earlier from Roman Reigns, and Triple H threw Roman headfirst into the chair. Now Cesaro does the same thing to Matt. Ow. That has got to hurt, as Cesaro's looking for another weapon. Ooh, a ladder. Alright. Matt makes him drop the ladder. Oh, and another European uppercut. Okay, Matt gets up. Cesaro blocked the punch. Oh, Cesaro. Here we go. Cesaro with the sharpshooter. You can't win on the outside, but you can definitely wear your opponent out. Oh, sharpshooter. That'll hurt the back. But Matt with the back elbow. Oh, and an elbow. A running elbow. Oh, and he takes the replica title belt and he's just beating Cesaro with it now. Oh, big shot to the face. Alright. Put the title down, Matt. Put the title down. Thank you. Now, oh, looking for a table. Cesaro down. This could be the opportunity to grab it. Nope. Oh, and a backdrop on the floor. Cesaro got the advantage back. Oh, he drops the knee again. Oh, drops another knee. Again, hits two knees in a row. Oh, kick. Oh, Matt with the punches. Oh, Cesaro blocks the punch. Oh, Matt counters. Oh, now Matt with the submission on the outside. The double underhook unlock. Oh, Cesaro using his hard head against him. Oh, Matt with a drop kick. And the ladder goes flying over to the side. Oh, misses the elbow. Oh, Cesaro misses the knee. Oh, Matt slams him down to the floor. And now Matt takes the crutch. Where are all these people getting these crutches, okay? Literally. Where are these people getting the crutches? And I hope they don't need them. Because they will not get them back. Oh! Cesaro counters. Matt counters. And Cesaro thrown into the steel steps. And out. Thrown into the ring. This is Matt's opportunity. Oh, here we go. Into the corner. Oh! Oh, Matt! Oh, Matt Hardy! He's got Cesaro! Twist of fate off the top rope! Twist of fate off the top rope. Cesaro's done. One, two, three. Cesaro is done. Matt Hardy beat Cesaro. And that means I am up 5-1 on Tyson right now. Very, very good for me. As I'll show you the replays right now. Matt just slamming him down on the floor. Well, Cesaro countered, but Matt countered right away. And then here we go. Here's what ended it. The twist of fate off the top rope. God, you don't see Matt pull that out often, but when he does, it always ends the match. And twist of fate, 1, 2, 3. Matt Hardy representing me picks up a win. And I'll see when we get back to the main menu. Wow. So Matt Hardy beat Cesaro with the twist of fate off the top rope, and okay. But anyway, let's get into Kevin Owens and Dolph Ziggler. Of course, I'm hoping Owens wins. Tyson would be hoping that Ziggler wins. Let's see who does, though. Let the computer fight. I'll see you when the entrances start.
Sometimes a superstar just has that look in his eye, and this is one of those times. I don't recall the last time I've been this excited for a rollback. Oh man, this is gonna be great!
Okay. Kevin Owens. Alright, let's get into it. Ziggler and Owens. Oh, Owens wrist lock. Oh, Ziggler. Oh, Ziggler counters with a big step up enziguri. Bring him up to his feet. Owens blocks the punch, got that wrist lock again. Oh, and he body slams him on the arm. That was a beautiful maneuver by Kevin Owens. Oh, Ziggler, belly to belly. Oh, Owens moves out the way of the elbow. Oh, and a huge clothesline. JBL would be proud of that one. Get it? Because it's JBL's clothesline. And then Ziggler answers back with a clothesline of his own. Now Ziggler with that wrist lock, but Owens counters with a knee to the gut. Oh, and Owens runs straight into a drop kick. Oh, now Owens with that belly to belly. Oh, Kevin with the backbreaker. Oh, Kevin's already going out for the weapons. Looking for the table. Will Dolph let him get it? No, he will not. Oh, and there's a big clothesline. Flying clothesline by Dolph. Oh, move out the way of the super kick. And Owens grabs the steel steps. Puts him down. If I was Owens, I would have used those steel steps as protection. Oh, but instead he gets slammed headfirst on the steel steps. Oh, and another flying clothesline by Ziggler. Oh, nice elbow. Oh, headfirst off the post. And again headfirst off the post, thrown back inside the ring. Now, Kevin was also trying to grab a kendo stick, it looked like, but guess not. Ziggler got the side headlock on the outside. And oh. Owens managed to stop himself before colliding with the steel steps. And headbutt to the back of the neck. And now Kevin. Oh, he pulled out, I believe, a steel chair is what that looked like. But again, Ziggler made him drop it. Oh, Owens. Oh, he put Ziggler back in the ring. Oh. Shot to the throat and a kick to the back of the head. We've seen that a few times here tonight. Oh, now Owens, every time he puts Ziggler back in the ring, he looks for a weapon. But Ziggler won't let him pull it out all the way. He did pull that one out from the ring completely, but Ziggler again made him drop it. Oh, Ziggler back elbow and another clothesline. If Owens keeps eating those clotheslines, Ziggler will easily win. Oh, got the steel chair, puts it down, and that's going to cost him, maybe. Oh, big clothesline by Owens after he caught the foot. Oh, and then it just stomps him, stomp to the face. Oh, and that's the fourth flying clothesline of this match by Ziggler. And he drops the knee. You got to stop eating that clothesline. I'm Kevin. Seriously, if you want to win. And I want you to win. Oh, and Ziggler with a power slam. And Ziggler. Oh, he's going to make him humble. He's going to try and make him humble. The camel clutch. Oh, Ziggler lets it go, just wanted to wear him down a little bit. Owens blocks the punch, got him in the wrist lock again, on a big just straightforward forearm, floats over in a DDT. Well, all the weapons right there on the floor, I mean, I'm surprised if Ziggler didn't, like, his head didn't bounce off one of them. Oh, here we go. On a gut buster. On a running senton. Oh, big shot to the face. All right, Ziggler throws him to the barricade. Oh, big right hand. You know, just like a few other people of the night, Ziggler raining down the right hands, punching him right in the face. Oh, here we go. Back suplex into a kip up. Beautiful maneuver. On DDT on the floor. That thin padding protecting the concrete floor. Oh, and reverse DDT. Oh, look at this. Sleeper hold. But if you knock him out, if you KO, it doesn't matter. Oh, Owens is tapping out, but it doesn't matter. You have to get the win on the inside of the ring. Owens gets up. Oh, here we go. Oh, no. No. Kev, don't. Oh! The reverse power bomb. Oh, that looks brutal every time he hits it. Now he's looking for a trash can so he can take out the trash. Oh, Ziggler counters. Hip toss. Bringing him up to his feet. Oh, Kev blocks the punch. Goes behind. Oh, not a full Nelson trying to get revenge. Oh, Dolph fights out of the full Nelson. Oh, now Dolph with the full Nelson. Well, Kev... and again... Kevin's submitting, but it doesn't matter. You have to beat him on the inside of the ring. You have to get him on the inside of the ring to win. So Kevin can submit all he wants, but the match won't end. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, thank god. I thought he was going for the package pile driver on the floor. But no, it was just the power bomb. As Ziggler hits the belly to belly on the floor. Oh, now Ziggler with the gut buster. Driving both knees into the stomach. Oh, looks like he's going to do it again. And that's exactly what he's going to do. The big gut buster, two in a row. Oh, going to do it for a third time? No, he's not. Kevin gets off the shoulders and a DDT driving him straight into the floor. Oh, Kev gets his foot. I'm caught. Now... Dolph Ziggler with a single leg Boston Crab. And Kevin's tapping out again, but again, it doesn't matter. That's the third time Kevin Owens has tapped out, but it does not matter unless you get him in the ring, Dolph. As Dolph hits a neck breaker. Dolph could have won this match on three consecutive occasions as he hits another neck breaker. Three consecutive occasions Dolph could have won. If he would have just got him in the ring. Oh my god! Dolph counter with a drop toe and Kevin Owens literally bounced head first off those steel steps. Big sit out face buster. Kevin busted wide open. Oh, and Kevin. There is the back body drop on the floor. And Kevin finally getting the match back in the ring. One big move on either man and the match will be over. And that's exactly what Kevin Owens is looking to do. Pop up, powerbomb, the match is over. Count to three, ref. Two, three, Kevin Owens has won. Sorry, Dolph, you had three consecutive occasions to win the match. You didn't take it. Kevin took advantage. You're eliminated from the tournament. And that means I'm 6-1 on Tyson Superstars. Tyson, whatever we do for the next tournament, you gotta bring it. Because the people you drafted, they're not doing the job for you. So whatever the next tournament is, whether you're involved or not, if you are, you gotta bring it, man. But see, pop-up powerbomb, ref can count to 100. And I'll see you when we get back to the main menu. Wow. Kev won. That's great. For me, it's like I'm up literally 6-1. And going to the final match of the first round. Tyson, dude, you need to have Sami Zayn beat Christian. You need Sami to win, because you can't have you can't just depend on Daniel. I mean, sure, Daniel's an amazing wrestler, but he's one guy against, right now, my six other guys that represent me. Possibly seven if Christian does beat Sami. So, yeah. But anyway, let's get into it, but I will see you when we get into the match. Sami Zayn, great wrestler, but there's not many people who can actually beat the caliber of this man, Captain Charisma. Intercontinental Champion, former World Heavyweight Champion, former, I believe, 7-time Tag Team Champions. He's won world titles in all the promotions. Christian is the man. He is one of the best in-ring performers and one of the most hilarious dudes you'll ever see in a wrestling ring. Especially when he's with Edge. Which he very well might face Edge in this tournament later. Who knows? But, yeah. I'll see you when the match starts. Okay, match has started. Sami Zayn and Christian. Oh, Sami counters. Big shoulder block. Bring him up to his feet. Oh, some big punches. Oh, Christian makes sure he couldn't hit the drop kick. Goes behind. Oh, turns around quickly and hits the big jawbreaker. Whew. That's a really good move. Oh, Sami was thrown hard into the turnbuckle. Oh, but now he's got the wrist lock. Snapmare. And elbow to the back of the neck. Christian will fold that one in the morning. But a big flying forearm. Oh, Sami with a sunset flip powerbomb. With a great move. Oh, Sami goes behind. And a reverse DDT, and I think that's a little bit disrespectful from Sami, you know? Because if you know, Christian has made famous the reverse DDT in the WWE, you know? He was one of the first people to actually use it. In fact, he's beat people with, you know, that very same reverse DDT. But hey, that's all right. Oh, Christian. Couple of back elbows to the face, stopping Sami in his tracks. Collar bow tie up right in the middle of the ring. Sami gets the upper hand. On big Hurricane Rana. Oh, Sammy drops the elbow. Looks like he's going to look for a weapon. Going to pull out the trash can. Oh. That's the way it's gone all night. As Sammy retaliates from the jawbreaker from earlier with one of his own. But that's the way you know it has gone all night. One person will go out to get a weapon and then after they do, like, they won't be able to use it. Steel steps versus trash can. I wonder what's gonna win. Oh, Christian sets the steel steps down now. Sammy pummeling him with that trash can. Oh, Christian managed to roll out the way. Oh, and a big kick. Trash can goes flying. Oh, Christian, you looking for a ladder? You don't want Christian near a ladder, Sammy. Oh my God, flapjack directly on those steel steps. Oh God, that had to hurt. Oh, Christian, he drops the steel steps and falls to the floor. Oh, big step up into Gary. Beautiful. Oh, now Sammy throws Christian back in the ring. He does not follow. Christian comes back to the outside. Alright, here we go. A big kick. Christian wants some punches. Sammy blocks the chop. Now Christian throws Sammy back into the ring. Big elbow to the face. Is Christian gonna follow? No, he's not. He's gonna look for another weapon. He didn't find anything. Yeah, Christian didn't find anything under the ring, so, alright. But he stopped Sammy from looking for something. Oh, now, sunset flip powerbomb right next to that trash can. Ooh, Christian's lucky. But, Sammy kicks the arm, drops the elbow on the midsection. Oh, Sammy throwing some punches. Now Christian blocked the chop. Sammy moves out the way of the flying forearm. Oh, blocking each other's punches. Christian's got him. Sammy again blocks the chop. And there's for the third time in the match, the sunset flip powerbomb. Christian landing on the exposed concrete near the announce table. Oh, Christian reverses. Kick to the midsection. Oh, now here we go. He's got Sammy up and slams him straight down on face first on the floor. The inverted suplex. Oh, Christian again looking for the ladder and he can't grab it. Oh, Sammy counters. Oh, Christian reverses the drop kick. Now he's got the other set of steps. Oh, Sammy managed to get out of the way. Oh, and Christian hits him with another flapjack on the floor. Sammy counters, elbow to the face. Oh, blocks the punch. Oh, blocks the punch. Blocks the punch. Oh, Christian finally gets one. Because you know what they say, fourth time charm. Oh, and a hammerlock by Christian. Big hammerlock. Can Sammy get out of the hammerlock? Oh, and a punch to the leg. Oh, thrown into the steel steps. Oh, Sammy managed to move out of the way, though. Not the steel steps, the steel post, I mean. Oh, Christian counters. Oh, look at this. Sammy's got him up and Bryan Buster on the floor! Oh my God! Sammy breaking out, move from his indie days. With a big Bryan Buster directly on the floor. The only thing that could be worse is a Bryan Buster on the but the exposed turnbuckle. If you're El Generico fan, you know what I'm talking about. But Christian gets him back in the ring, and there's that elbow again. Is Christian finally going to follow him back inside the ring? No, he does not. Looks, Sammy, or just stare down right now. Sammy comes back to the outside. Oh, Sammy with a couple of big punches. Oh, and a big calf kick. Oh, bringing him up to his feet. Oh, here we go. Half and half. And I don't know how that didn't go on the trash can. I don't know, guys. Oh, but Sam, oh God, Sam is getting the equalizer. The equalizer! And that again is my terrible impression of Triple H. Let me know if you remember what episode or what series that was from. But I said that on commentary. Oh, here we go. Oh! Christian slams him down on the back of his head. Oh, pulls him up, goes behind again. Oh, Sammy counters. Oh, Christian counters. Oh, and Sammy with a drop kick. Sorry if you heard that burp. I'm very sorry. But Sammy hits the drop kick. Oh, hits the calf kick again. Right now, Sammy's got the advantage. And kind of very clearly got the advantage. As he's waiting for Christian to get back to his feet. Oh, he blocks it. It looked like Sammy was going for a submission. And, you know, if he was, that's the same situation, you know, that Dolph was in last match as Edge hits the edge of Matt, or Christian hits the edge of Matic, move up from his best friend. But yeah, if Sammy was going for a submission, that'd be the same situation that Dolph was in. Because Dolph made Kevin Owens in that last match tap out 3 times on the outside, but it didn't matter because you have to win on the inside. It's not false count anywhere, it's just extreme rules. Sammy couldn't find anything, and Christian's gonna make him pay for it. Oh, spins him around. And atomic drop. Oh, kick to the gut. Spins him around. Oh, Sammy counters. Kick to the back of the leg. Oh, he pushes the steel steps over. Oh, going back and forth with the punches. Christian misses. Sammy misses. Oh. Oh, now, here's the guillotine choke. Here's the guillotine choke. But again, it doesn't matter if you make a tap on the outside. You have to get the win on the inside. Oh, Christian. Oh. Oh, the power of Christian. Just throwing Sammy off. Oh, now. Christian thrown over the steel steps. Oh, here we go. Blue Thunder Bomb. Blue Thunder Bomb on the floor. Now Christian throws him back in the ring. Elbow to the face. That's the third time he's done that in this match. Now Christian running to the opposite side of the ring. Now Christian getting back in the ring. Oh, Sammy. He's got him up. And oh, the suplex neckbreaker. The final cut. That's a move of Goldust. Oh, Sammy counters, drop to hold. Oh no, Sammy. He wants to put the match away. Oh, here we go. Sammy with the Brain Buster. He's got that Brain Buster again, and the match is over. 1, 2, 3. And Sami Zayn has picked up the win. Congratulations, Tyson. You now have 2 superstars advancing to round 2. Very good for him. He needed that. Sammy picks up the win. I think it would be very interesting if Sammy won. And to tell you the truth, guys, right now, Sami Zayn is one of my favorite current wrestlers. Along with Chris Jericho and AJ Styles. But here we go. Here's the Brain Buster. The second one in the match. First one in the ring. And Sammy managed to pick up the win. Very great for him. But, that'll be the end of round 1. Stay tuned next week for round 2. And I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. If you did, leave a like and comment down below. Until next time, guys, I will see you later. Bye, guys.